Good morning, students. Welcome to my YouTube channel. This is your English teacher Manoj Kumar Verma. Today I am going to teach you a new chapter from your textbook, The First Flight. The name of the chapter is Awaken from Goa. This story is written by Professor Lucio Rodrigues. Professor Lucio Rodrigues is a prominent literary genius of Goa. He was the professor of Indiana University, USA, in 1969. His art of writing was very important, very prominent, very good, very effective, very influential. In this story, he has highlighted his own childhood memories before us, whatever he has experienced over here. Before that, I would focus something about the historical background of it. In fact, Goa was invaded by Portuguese, and if Portuguese in the year of 1510. Portuguese ruled in Goa up to 450 years. The Portuguese defeated Goan Sultanate, Bijapur Sultanate, and ruled over here for a long time. So this is and after just after invading, the Portuguese changed and influenced the Goan culture, cuisine, and architecture. In fact, when the Portuguese came, they started their business as a, they were the trader also, so start their business as a baker in Goa. So as a baker, they are popularly known as padar in Goa. So they appears two times in a day. First, in the morning, when they came to the village, taking a big basket, putting on one hand, and on the other hand there is a bamboo, he was thudding on the ground, and there is a jingling sound produced at the top of the bamboo. This jingling sound just indicates or just announces the arrival of the padar in Goan villas. Their arrival is really very unique. Whenever they arrive in the village to sell their bread, the women and the children were highly influenced. The padars were the good guide, companion, and friends to the children. They had very good behavior. So whenever the children assembled and gathered all around the basket, they just pushed aside with a mild rebuke. They sold bread for the women and bangle bread for the children. The children were highly influenced by the fragrance of the bread. So they climbed up on the benches and other places, other high platform, and took the fragrance and enjoy a lot. Whenever they eat the bread, the children did not care for brushing their teeth, because they said that who care for brushing the teeth, because tiger never brush the teeth. They did not prefer to took the mango leaf and brush it off. So this is what they used to do. Their arrival were very, very unique in the Goan villages. In the morning, when they came with the full basket of bread, and in the evening they appeared when they emptied their basket. Two times they were seen. the bread were so popular in Goan people, among the Goan people, Goan village, that no marriage, no party, no feast, no dad daughter's engagement, no Christmas or other festival could be successful without the use of bread of that parents. The woman make sandwiches with the help of bread. At the engagement of her daughter, during the Christmas, the cake, special type of cake, were also sold by the baker. Their behavior, their nature was so impressive that people attracted on them. Very humorously we can say that their appearance were very bulky. Their appearance seems to be like a jackfruits. They put on a type of dress. They put on the pant that is below the knee, shorter than the full pant, and shorter than the full pant and bigger than the half pant. This type of dress they used to put on. Their appearance were black, but they were very bulky. Their profession was so rich that their family were highly satisfied with the profession. So the maintenance of account made by the baker in Goa were also very interesting. They write down the line on the wall, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like that, and at the end of the month they went to collect the money from the house where they supplied the bread. So the presence of baker in the Goan village were very important. The profession was highly profitable. Still in the present time, this culture, this art of selling is still available. Their business was not extinct from the Goa. Their father, their ancestors were no more, but their son still survived with that traditional business established by their ancestors. This is what is in this chapter, a baker from Goa. Okay, dear student, I hope this video will be very fruitful. If you go through this story and see the video, you will enjoy a lot about the art, culture and behavior of the Goan baker, that is popularly known as the padar in Goa. Okay, thank you very much.